This week, Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate the World Breastfeeding Week. This is an annual global campaign that aims to raise awareness and promote benefits of breastfeeding. This year, the event was celebrated under the theme, Closing the Gap, Breastfeeding Support for All. This calls for workplaces to set up conducive breastfeeding spaces and policies that support new mothers, making breastfeeding banks available to all, as well as support extended to breastfeeding mothers, especially the vulnerable groups.
Only 78% of the mothers initiate breastfeeding within the first hour after delivery. And when we look at also our statistics, 63% of the mothers exclusively breastfeed. Our target would have loved every woman actually to breastfeed their infants for the first 6 months of life and continue breastfeeding. But we have challenges around this.
In Uganda, breastfeeding is deeply rooted in the cultural traditions and has been the primary method of infant breastfeeding for generations. However, with the advancing world, many mothers have to work. They have abandoned exclusive breastfeeding for formula, while others may have justifiable reasons that may require artificial feeding. Susan Tabu, the senior principal nursing officer at Arua Regional Referral Hospital, shared her own experience of artificial breastfeeding after giving birth to preterm triplets, which she noted can also be expensive.
Artificial feed is very expensive in terms of buying the milk. This formulated milk, this which I believe many mothers cannot afford. Even those who are working, I will give you an experience of my own. I once gave birth to preterm babies, and because they were born premature, they do not have that energy to suckle in order to stimulate the breast milk. And also, these babies were delivered by cesarean section. So since they were not breastfeeding, I started the first week, I was expressing manually. I expressed for 1 week. The breast milk was no longer enough for the three babies. So I bought this manual breast milk extractor. I used it for 1 week. After 1 week, the milk that it would extract was not enough. When I reached the fifth week, I resorted to using the electrical breast milk extractor. It worked for me only for 1 week. The second week, the amount had totally reduced.
It's again such a background that activists this week only called on the government to ensure all workplaces have breastfeeding spaces, but to ensure general hospitals nationwide have breast milk banks. It is against this background that activists this week not only called on the government to ensure all workplaces have breastfeeding spaces, but to ensure general hospitals nationwide have breast milk banks. The health and gender ministries have also over the years worked towards ensuring that working mothers get 6 months of leave from the initial 3 months.
The working mothers are entitled for maternity leave of 60 working days. This is equivalent to 3 months, but this is not sufficient. So we encourage these mothers actually to bring their babies to the working places. And that's why this year we are really emphasizing that the working places should have at least breastfeeding corners where these mothers can go and breastfeed their babies and then get back to work.
During the critical period of early growth and development, the antibodies in breast milk protect babies against illness and death. When breastfeeding is protected and supported, women are more than twice likely to breastfeed their infants. This is a shared responsibility for families, communities, healthcare workers, policymakers, and other decision makers by ensuring increased investment in programs and policies that protect and support breastfeeding. Implementation of family-friendly working policies such as paid maternity leave, breastfeeding breaks, and access to affordable and good quality child care. Mothers at risk in emergencies or underrepresented communities receive breastfeeding support in line with their unique needs, including timely, effective breastfeeding counseling as part of routine health coverage, as well as improved monitoring of breastfeeding programs and policies.